Dear students, this is lecture number 4 on the topic steam turbine. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the reaction turbines. So before we take the reaction turbine, we look at the diagram. There are two turbines, impulse turbine and the reaction turbine. The impulse turbine we have discussed earlier lectures. And what do you see in the impulse turbine? You can easily recognize. So this is something like a Pelton turbine. You have a rotor and a set of nozzles. And the nozzle is converting the steam energy, enthalpy of the steam, into velocity. With this velocity, the velocity of the steam, the jet of the steam, is impinging on the rotor, which makes the rotor to rotate and produce the power. So here we have a nozzle. So the green color is the nozzle, fixed nozzle. It is attached to the casing of the machine, and we got the moving blade. So the purpose of the moving blade is to convert the velocity of the steam into work done. And look at the change in the pressure and the velocity. So steam pressure decreases across the nozzle, and the pressure remains constant in the moving blade. So in the impulse turbine, the pressure remains constant across the moving blade. And in the velocity, look at the velocity. Velocity is increasing in the nozzle. So the drop in pressure is converted into increase in velocity, and the velocity is utilized in the moving blade to produce the power. So you look at the reaction turbine now. So here we have fixed blade and moving blade. Right, so this is fixed blade and moving blade. So look at the pressure change. The pressure drop takes place both in the fixed blade and the moving blade. The fixed blade act as a nozzle. The rotating blade is also acting as a nozzle. So it is called as rotating nozzle. So what is a nozzle? It decreases the pressure and increases the kinetic energy. So here, so in the rotating nozzle, so the pressure drop takes place both in the fixed blade and the moving blade in the case of a reaction turbine. So the velocity, considering the velocity, so for the nozzle pressure drop, there is increase in velocity. So the velocity is used in the moving blade. So if you look at the moving blade, there is pressure drop as well as the velocity drop. So the work produced by the rotor blade in a reaction turbine is the sum of work due to the drop in pressure and work due to the drop in velocity, decrease in velocity. So we look at the reaction turbine in detail. So the reaction turbine, a single stage reaction turbine, consists of fixed blade and moving blade. So the blade shapes are symmetrical, blade shapes are equal, and this type of shape is called as aerofoil shape. And look at the blade 1, blade 2. So the area between the blade 1, blade 2, look at the area. So initially it is higher. As the flow is taking place here, the area is decreasing and then increasing. So the flow passage between adjacent blades, it is something like a converging diverging nozzle. Similarly, in the moving blade also, the similar type of arrangement is there. Initially the larger area, then converging area, then diverging area. So the space between fixed blade, adjacent fixed blade or adjacent moving blade, it acts as a converging diverging nozzle. So what happens for the pressure? Pressure drop takes place in the fixed blade and in the moving blade. So the pressure drop in the fixed blade and in the moving blade. What about the velocity? So for this pressure drop, there is increase in velocity, and this velocity is used in the moving blade. So considering the moving blade, the pressure drop, there is drop in pressure, decrease in pressure, as well as decrease in velocity. So both are happening. The power produced by the moving blade is the sum, is the power produced due to decrease in velocity and decrease in the pressure. That is the reaction turbine. So the velocity triangle is very much similar to the previous one. So you have to draw the velocity triangle carefully. So absolute velocity, tangential velocity, flow velocity, relative velocity, theta is the blade angle, alpha is the nozzle angle, phi is the blade angle at the outlet, beta is the now angle of the velocity V2, velocity Vf to flow velocity, Vr to relative velocity, blade velocity, and the tangential velocity. So the velocity triangle is very much similar to the impulse turbine. Now, what is the power produced in the reaction turbine? Power produced, the equation is also the same. M into Vw1 plus Vw2 into Vb. There is a change in the equation. So into Vb. So M into Vw1 plus Vw2 into Vb. Vb is the blade velocity. And axial thrust on the blade equal to M into Vf1 minus Vf2. And here in the reaction turbine, we have to calculate the mass flow rate of the steam, which is pi dm into h. So M equal to area into velocity divided by specific volume, Av by small v. So area is pi dm into h. Dm, mean diameter of the drum, rotor drum, and h is the height of the blade, Vf2 is the flow velocity, and the small vs is the specific volume of the steam from the steam table. This data you have to collect from the steam table. And in the reaction turbine, one important parameter is degree of reaction. Degree of reaction R is defined as enthalpy drop in the moving blade divided by enthalpy drop in the stage, entire turbine. So enthalpy drop in the moving blade is the change in the relative velocity, Vr2 square minus Vr1 square divided by 2. So this is due to the change in the enthalpy or change in the pressure across the moving blade. Enthalpy drop in the stage equal to the work produced, Vb into Vw1 plus Vw2. So substituting from the velocity triangle for the velocity vector, finally we will get R equal to Vf by 2 Vb into cot phi minus cot theta, or R equal to 1 by 2 plus Vf by 2b into 2vb into cot phi minus cot alpha. The degree of reaction, it varies from 0 to 1. Now, normally the reaction turbine is designed for 50% reaction turbine. So, we will look at the conditions for 50% reaction turbine. For 50% reaction turbine, the name of the turbine is partial reaction turbine. What is the condition? What are the conditions? There is no change in the flow velocity. Vf1 equal to Vf2 equal to Vf. So that means there is no axial thrust. So Vf1 equal to Vf2, that means there is no axial thrust. So when the velocity V1 equal to Vr2, V2 equal to Vr1, and phi equal to alpha, theta equal to beta. So you look at the velocity triangle here. So in this velocity triangle, V1 equal to Vr2. For 50% reaction turbine, V1 equal to Vr2. Vf1 equal to Vf2. Vr1 equal to V2. Alpha equal to phi. Theta equal to beta. Vw1 equal to Vb plus Vw2. That is what the condition. So, for 50% reaction turbine. So, using all these conditions, we can conclude that for a reaction turbine, the velocity triangles are symmetrical. The velocity triangles are symmetrical. So the mirror image. So the exit velocity triangle is the mirror image of the inlet velocity triangle. Then comparison between impulse and the reaction turbine. For the impulse turbine, pressure decreases only in the nozzle and remains constant in the moving blade. This is the condition. The pressure constant across the moving blade. But in the case of reaction turbine, pressure decreases both in the fixed blade and the moving blade. Impulse turbine, the steam may not be admitted over the whole circumference because we have a nozzle, the jet of the steam is produced. So the whole circumference, admitting for the entire circumference is not required. Whereas in the reaction turbine, we have to, the steam must be admitted over the whole circumference. For impulse turbine, relative velocity remains constant for frictionless flow. That is what the condition we have discussed, right? For frictionless flow, Vr1 equal to Vr2. When k equal to 1, Vr1 equal to Vr2. Relative velocity is constant. Whereas in the reaction turbine, relative velocity increases across the moving blade. So Vr2 always greater than Vr1. So in the impulse turbine, blades are symmetrical. So in the reaction turbine, blades are not symmetrical. So in the case of impulse turbine, number of stages required is less, because per stage the pressure drop, the velocity and the pressure drop is higher, the power generation is higher. So in the case of reaction turbine, number of stages required is more for the same power output. Area of the blade channel is constant in the case of impulse turbine, whereas in the case of reaction turbine, area of the blade channel is varying. Efficiency is low in the case of impulse turbine because of the higher exit velocity. In the case of reaction turbine, the efficiency is higher. Blade manufacture is easy because of the symmetrical blading. So here, blade manufacture is difficult because of the aerofoil type of blade. Impulse turbine required lesser space, because why it is required lesser space? Number of stages are less, so you require only lesser space. So the number of stages are more here, you require more space. So the impulse turbine is suitable for small power requirement, whereas reaction turbine is suitable for higher or medium power requirement. So thank you. We'll meet in the next lecture.